The Busia District Veterinary Department has so far confirmed 10 cases of rabies disease. The cases have been reported in the sub-counties of Majanji, Busime, Lumino, Buhehe and Tabani, among others. Dr. Patrick Baraza, the Busia District Veterinary and Production Officer, said that the samples from the animals were taken to Entebbe Veterinary Lab that confirmed the presence of the rabies disease. He confirmed that some patients who were bitten by the same animals tested positive for the disease.
Here towards the control of rabies, we've had rabies outbreak in the district. And this outbreak has continued from the period of February of this year up to date. And the outbreak is unique because unlike other outbreaks where rabies has been mediated by dogs, in this one here we have it mediated by foxes. And the outbreak has been continuous up to date. We have even had a case of a fox bite as recent as 2nd of September. So we are seeing the outbreak continuing, but very unique because it's fox mediated.
Veterinary department, baba deba tuwa information eno, and ba confirming that this is what they reported. Wadenga si nyingi na hizi badeo. So tulikozesa means hizo ne zisoboka okulaba nti ezo cases ziri reported zibera handled no preventing others.
Rabies is caused by a virus that spreads through the saliva of infected animals. These infected animals can then spread the virus by biting another animal or a person, affecting the central nervous system. In up to 99% of the human rabies cases, dogs are responsible for the virus transmission, and children between the age of 5 and 14 years are frequent victims.
In the communities, first of all, they wanted to find, is there an upsurge in the number of foxes, which they have actually confirmed, because the community was even able to lead them to some of the areas where these foxes were. So now the debate that is there is whether these foxes should be relocated, but also when you relocate, would you relocate the disease? So that is the challenge that we have, but I think discussions are taking place to see what should be done to try to intervene and save the population from these fox bites.
In the case of Busia, district officials say that it is caused by foxes and stray dogs that have been spotted in the affected areas. Peter Mayende, the village health coordinator for Dabani sub-county, says they are overwhelmed with stray dogs whose owners are negligent. However, Baraza also faulted dog owners for not vaccinating their pets.
Of course, rabies is a disease of public good. The vaccines are provided by the center, but the law provides that if you have a dog, you must present it for vaccination. And also provides for keeping your dog under leash, should be confined. But like the situation that is in Busia, we have a number of dogs that are stray. And not stray because they have no owners, but stray because they are just moving of their own accord, probably because they have not been fed. So that's one of the challenges that we have, that the stray dogs that we have are actually owned. So we should now get back, I think, the sub-counties and try to come up with bylaws to ensure that people take control of their owners. We are currently taking up a register of all pets in the district with the support from the VHCs and the community, and I think we should be having a register so that we start following up the dogs that have been vaccinated and those that have been vaccinated.
According to the World Health Organization, dog bites and scratches cause 99% of the human rabies cases and can be prevented through dog vaccination and bite prevention.
Embwa singa tebagigemye embwa ndaziberamu obulwadde naye singa bagigemye tebira na bulwadde awo singa erumu omuntu naye tabira na kabi konna bamujanja bujanja bi treatment etono omuntu ate naye nga webera na n'obulwadde.
It is against this background that the Busia District Veterinary Department has embarked on mass vaccination of dogs and cats.
Issues as immunization, please discussing.
So we are carrying out control measures, and one of the intervention areas that we have had is vaccination of the pets and dogs. which is actually ongoing now. The program has been drawn. We have also had a team from Uganda Wildlife Authority coming in to come and assess where actually these foxes are coming from.
On top of vaccinating, the officials are also conducting community sensitization about the disease and encouraging dog owners to keep their pets on leashes.